A Philippine congressional inquiry into the disappearance of an inmate uncovers a host of problems in the country's prison facilities. RG Cruz reports.
Emerging from a closed-door session with the House Committee on Public Order and Safety, the Secretary of Justice admitted he relayed erroneous information about the case of a missing inmate from the New Bilibid prisons.
Na fake news po ako na nahanap ang katawan na putol ang ulo.
Hindi po ako nagbigay noon ng information. Ang ginawa ko muna is declare ko siya ng missing dahil hindi ko rin masabi na based on our investigation, hindi naman siya nakatakas.
Last week, it was Remulla who confirmed that there was a decapitated body found in the septic tank of the NBP and that the body belongs to a missing PDL. The Corrections Bureau is now looking for the inmate outside the penitentiary. Remulla was scanned about the state of affairs inside the penitentiary.
An example would be the New Bilibid prison in Muntinlupa, which was built to house a capacity of 5,700 people, now housing more than 36,000 people. Managing this population has been horrific. There's no book written that will tell you how to manage a prison population of this number, of this magnitude.
We are now unable to effectively manage the PDL with the current strength of Bucor personnel.
Remulla concedes rich and poor inmates are not treated equally. Remulla adds inmates are forced to ask their relatives to send food and other necessities, but they also have to pay off the jail guards.
Ang budget po para sa pagkain ng isang preso sa isang araw ay 70 pesos a day. Tatlong meals na po ito. Yung GCash system, meron pa hong komisyon ng mga gwardiya ng 10 to 20% bago hong makarating yung pera sa mga tao. Wala hong makain ng mga tao. Isa po yan sa mga pinakamalaking problema ng jail natin. Survival po ang survival of the fittest, law of the jungle.
Philippine lawmakers also questioned the supposed perks enjoyed by inmates at the Bureau of Corrections. Bucor officials admit detainees can use mobile phones and even have visitors stay for as long as 1 week. Bucor Chief Gregorio Catapang explains many of the benefits are long-established customs inside the facility even before he took over.
Mayroong gusto makakausap parati yung kamag-anak niya, no? Yung guardia niya mismo nagdadala ng cellphone kung mag-talk and text lang, mga 50,000. Kung may makikita o smartphone siya, 100,000. Yan po yung itinatanggal namin na kultura sa kanila.
PDL na ang kumokontrol. Ang totoo niyan, mayroong partnership yung mga gwardiya saka yung PDL tungkol dito.
Authorities want to modernize the Bucor, build new and modern facilities around the country, including a separate facility for convicts of heinous crimes and foreigners. They also want to go into business with the private sector to fund these projects.
We envision converting the greater portion of the New Bilibid prison reservation into a Bucor global city. We will explore the advantage of a public-private partnership as our modality for this project.
For Deputy Director for Operations Officer in Charge, Angelina Bautista, some of the benefits are covered by the rules in their prison manual. But House panel members are unconvinced and vowed to review the NBP's operations manual. They have agreed to conduct an ocular inspection of the jail facility to check on the situation firsthand. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
Syndicated estafa charges are filed against the owner, captain, and crew of a passenger boat that capsized off the coast of Rizal Province. Vivian Gulia reports.
The owner, captain, and crew of MV Aya Express that capsized off the waters of Binangon and Rizal last Thursday are facing a fresh complaint. This time, it's syndicated estafa filed by the Philippine Coast Guard before the Provincial Prosecutor's Office in Rizal on Wednesday. The alleged offense is non-bailable, unlike the complaint for reckless imprudence resulting in multiple homicide, multiple physical injuries, and negligence that stemmed from the police investigation.
There's an element of deceit or fraud Very clear po yung manifest na sinabit po sa amin is 22 only. It is an act committed by more than 5 people.
27 passengers died in the tragic boat incident and 41 survived. The total figure is more than thrice the number of passengers listed in the manifest submitted by the boat captain to the PCG. Boat Captain Donald Anyain, who is detained in Binangonan, refused to respond to ABS-CBN's query on the complaint and on the validity of his license. Officers and members of the Talim Island Passenger Motorboat and Patrons Association, or TIPMOPA, were also named as respondents in the syndicated estafa complaint.
These are registered either SEC or Office of Transport Cooperative or Cooperative Development Association. Plus, they claim that they are the rightful representatives of the motor bank operatives.
TIPMOPA President Jeronimo Mendoza told ABS-CBN News in a text message that the group will wait for a copy of the complaint before issuing a comment. Meanwhile, the PCG has implemented stricter policies at the Binangonan port. Before the recent boat incident, motorcycles, rolls of garment, sacks of rice and other heavy cargoes are allowed on board passenger boats leaving the port. But now, only hand-carry items are allowed. Heavy loads have to be boarded to an all-cargo vessel.
Sasakay kami, tapos yung aming karga, may iwan din namin ako saan mabababa. Tapos kukunin namin doon sa ibang alapit barangay. Another pamasahin na naman.
Ayun nga pong kasama ng ang bagahe ay nawawalan ay yung pang mabukod.
Segregate natin muna yung mga heavy to a private motorbangka na willing kami temporarily to shoulder. Tatakbo yan, wala sakay yan kundi yung cargo plus siyempre yung caretaker na maglilista.
The local government of Binangonan and the PCG are set to meet again to discuss ways to address passengers' concerns without compromising their safety. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
The effectiveness of state flood control measures are put in question as floods persist in the provinces of Pampanga and Bulacan, Rafael Bosano reports.
Flooding has been the norm in Barangay Gugu, Kalumpit, Bulacan. The entire first floor of this home has been submerged for months, which was made even worse due to the monsoon rains.
May 18 pa lang, may tubig na dyan sa baba. Tapos, unti-unti na tumas yung babagyo o may bagyo. Tumataas ang tubig. Hanggang December nang kaganto kami.
The village chief says the last time farmers in Barangay Gugu reaped harvest was way back in 2018. This is why residents have opted to turn to fish pens. But even the fish pens were not spared by flooding.
Kami po kasi hindi kami masyadong pansinin yung aming barangay dahil nasa loob. Ang panawagan po namin sana mapasok kami ng mga nagbibigay ng ayuda. Lalong-lalo na po pagkain, tubig, ala po kaming kuryente.
In the town of Agonoy, tricycle drivers have decided to modify their vehicles to adjust to rising sea levels and flooding.
Dati po kasi mga baba lang yung sidecar namin. Nung hindi na po kami sabi-sunod na ng tubig, tinas na rin po namin para makabiyahe kami. Kung baba pa mataas, magtataas pa kami sa sakyan.
Aside from typhoons and monsoon rains, Bulacan Governor Daniel Fernando points to Bustos Dam releasing water because of substandard materials used for its gate.
Ang katotohanan po ay hindi pa nagagawa yung gates ng Bustos Dam kasi anin po itong gates na to. Yung isang gate ay nasira. Preemptive na pagpapakala. Okay. Natural naman yun. Medyo nagkari talaga ako dahil bakit biglang lumakas, naging 737 agad.
The National Irrigation Administration has earlier said that releasing water is necessary as Bustos is not a reservoir type of dam. Meanwhile, Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva is demanding answers from the Department of Public Works and Highways over its flood control project in the province. Despite criticisms, the Marcos administration is asking for an even higher budget for flood control projects of the DPWH next year. In neighboring Pampanga province, more than a dozen towns and cities are still flooded. Local disaster officials say more than 200 villages are submerged in flood waters. Floods continue to challenge not only residents but also motorists plying the North Luzon Expressway. The heavy traffic along NLEX has been hounding motorists for 5 days now, which is why its management has decided to put sandbags. But even then, the patience of those plying the expressway will still be put to the test. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News, Bulacan.
The Philippine government urged to ensure the immediate repairs of typhoon-hit schools ahead of the incoming school year this August. This as the Alliance of Concerned Teachers notes that around 160 schools across the country have been damaged by Typhoon Egay and the southwest monsoon. Classes in public schools will start on August 29.